Welcome all of you on your PD education, and you are watching the regular updates related to various opportunities abroad in higher education domain. Those of you who are interested to pursue their masters or PhD, so we are showing regular departments where you can get these kind of scholarships and regular courses. Some of the courses which are industry basically related courses, pursuing the courses, after the pursuing these courses you may get very good jobs in the industries. One of such courses, mechatronics, electronics, mechanical combined, and I'm going to discuss today about the opportunities or jobs in mechatronics in Norway universities. So you know, when I talk about some course, let's say fellowship program or doctorate program, that department also has opportunity for master's program. So this video is relevant for those students who are BTech and want to pursue masters, as well as those who are doing masters and want to go for PhD, and also those who have done PhD and now want to work as postdoctorate fellowship in these universities. So I will keep on covering all the domains. So if you are interested in mechatronics, you want to do MS in mechatronics, or you have already done MS in mechatronics, like in India there are some institute where M.Tech mechatronics is offered, something like IIT Patna if I'm not wrong, and some NITs also there is a mechatronics, and some more IITs there is a course on mechatronics and related domains, robotics, mechatronics. So agar aapne usme M.Tech kiya hai and you are done really good work, then you can get very good scholarship. And Norway universities, as I told you, is famous for offering you very good scholarship where you can save a really good amount of money in Indian currency, and you can pursue your PhD also, and after PhD good opportunities are offered. So these are Scandinavian countries, Norway, Sweden, I will discuss this Sweden also with you later on. These are very good countries to pursue higher education. Okay, so today I'm going to discuss about the University of Agder, A-G-D-E-R, if I'm pronouncing it properly. AGDER and PhD research fellow in mechatronics. So last date for that is 12th of July, that is what I found, and let me discuss this with you today. So this is the University of AGDER. I don't know how to pronounce this university. So this is the university, and this is they have advertised in the department. This is a research center of mechatronics under Department of Engineering Science, and they are offering this particular course there. So R&D project is there, and the project is related to AIM Wind. You know, one more thing you should know, that why PhDs in Europe are jobs, because whenever some project comes to the professor, he advertises a post of PhD for that project, and normally project is of duration of 3 to 4 years. So your PhD is clubbed with that project. The moment you complete your project, your PhD is also completed, though it is a fixed duration course, PhD course, fixed duration course, so that you can do it. Now in this particular this project, R&D project AIM Wind, analytics for asset integrity management of wind farms, that is what is written, that is what is mentioned. The good thing is that they have already mentioned in detail about the project. So what they expect in the project, what is to be done in the project, that everything is mentioned in the project. So main objective of AIM Wind is to improve life cycle cost of WF by improving availability during design life, extending the operation life beyond that period. So that is what is mentioned. Selecting the appropriate sensor, developing physics, data driven based methods. So if you go on the website, though they mentioned, so you people are going to work basically on development of enhanced diagnostics and prognostics for wind turbine rotating machinery. You know, that is actually the project. So if you go in detail about this project, if you go to the profile of the professor, you'll find more details about that. And I'm very sure those of you who are doing mechatronics in BTech or M.Tech, they will be aware about these projects. And I want to tell you one more thing also, direct PhD is also accepted in some of the universities, but your work should be really good. What they focus is, the most important thing is, what is your background of this project and how you can contribute into this project. So these jobs in Europe, direct jobs in Europe after BTech or M.Tech, are offered to those students who have done really good work in their engineering. And there will be interview, they will be interacting with you, professors will have interview session with you before you are finally inducted in these basically jobs. but in my opinion, if you have done really genuine work in your field, then you can get into that. What are the required qualifications? Indian students are to show their English proficiency, master's degree in mechanical, mechatronics, electrical engineering, or renewable energy. Anything, you know, when you join us, these courses in IITs or NITs like renewable energy courses, energy science, and even sustainable courses, sustainable energy domain courses. So all these courses can provide you opportunity to go for doctorate courses, doctorate in these particular countries. Only thing is you should have learned. So BIT M.Tech should be like this. And even final year student of the M.Tech can apply for this. TOEFL and this thing is required. And what else is required? The rest is, I think, very, very normal things. They are similar things. Desired qualification is, yes, you should have knowledge of signal processing and applied mathematics, machine learning. So, as I told you, that the moment you enter into IIT, you should have knowledge of MATLAB, Python, etc. You should have knowledge of MATLAB, Python, signal processing, and then mathematics, you know, applied mathematics, machine learning. Learn all these things. If you learn all these things, you say, yes, I have knowledge of machine learning, applied mathematics also, Python also, MATLAB also, and I have some kind of research papers also in M.Tech. So if you utilize 2 years in M.Tech, you can get very good jobs in these universities. You should have awareness. You should keep it as a target that immediately after my M.Tech, I'm going to join some job in these kind of universities. And when the moment you complete the project, you will get basically a very good job also in the same companies. Okay. So what are the personal qualities also they focus? That you should have bent of mind, research bent of mind. You should have that capability to pursue the research work independently. That thing is also required. So those excellent communication skills you should have. That is what they expect. To interact with others, you know, to interact with the customers or other stakeholders in the project, that is required. What they offer is, as we know, this is more or less fixed in Norway, that is, they will be offering you 4,82,000 kroner per annum. So that approximately comes out to be more than 42 lakh rupees per annum. So after tax and all, you can save more than 1.5 lakh rupees per month. So that is how it goes to. Application, how application is to be submitted, and last date is 12th. Of July, how application is to be submitted and what are the details. As I told you, you can directly mail them, you can directly call them. They are very responsive and they will respond to your calls, and whatever information you want, they will provide you. And they have given the details also of the professors. I believe the professors handling those projects, and if you mail these professors, they will also be telling you a very detailed way. They will explain the things to you, and if you have basically some kind of background, what they want, it is very easy for you to contact them. And the moment you contact, they say, okay, you apply, job is done. So that is what we want. That is what is the purpose of what we are doing M.Tech. So in my opinion, you should do your master's seriously so that
lot of opportunities after that. Thank you.